I'm planning on making a video about Babylon 5, a show I grew up with and very much loved. I recently produced a video on Deep Space Nine, as you know, so I think it's only fitting that I cover B5 as well, especially given what I'm going to talk about today. Did the writers and producers of Star Trek Deep Space Nine copy many of the ideas and concepts of Babylon 5? There does seem to be an uncanny resemblance between the two shows. The allegations of plagiarism have gone on for many years amongst fan communities online. I personally believe Deep Space Nine was heavily influenced by Babylon 5 and did indeed draw a little too much inspiration from that show. Babylon 5 was created by J. Michael Straczynski and began after Deep Space Nine aired. The reality is, Straczynski had pitched Babylon 5 to Paramount sometime prior to the development of Deep Space Nine. He presented them with a comprehensive series Bible that mapped out the story arc of the entire series, but Paramount rejected his pitch and moved forward with Deep Space Nine instead. Eventually, Straczynski got Babylon 5 off the ground on another network, but it was clear that the general premise and many of the details of Deep Space Nine were heavily influenced by Straczynski's Babylon 5 Bible. In an email written by Straczynski dated February 4th, 1992, to someone he'd been in correspondence with, he says, "When was Babylon 5 announced? Check the trades. November 21st, several articles appeared with the info. When was DS9 developed? That too is a matter of both record and other information. Was B5 brought to Paramount? Yes, it was. I have the correspondence to prove it. Were some of the development people at Paramount who read the B5 screenplay and saw the series treatment and Bible also involved in the DS9 development? It seems that this is indeed the case. That's not unsubstantiated BS, as you say, and I really don't care what you think on that subject. All of that is a matter of record." It seems likely that someone in Paramount held on to the Babylon 5 Bible and, at the very least, steered the production staff of Deep Space Nine in a particular direction based on Straczynski's work. In an interview from November 2017, actress Patricia Tallman, who played Lita on Babylon 5, said the following.
"Joe had gone to Paramount with the Bible for Babylon 5, pitched it to the Star Trek producers, left it with them for a year. They finally return it back to him saying, no, we're not going to do it. So he finds his own way to get Babylon 5 made. Meanwhile, they make Deep Space Nine. So there was a lawsuit, and they settled out of court. So, yeah, of course, they did. They ripped off the script and the idea. They had a character named Lita. They didn't even change it. I mean, there's just, you know, there's some things that were just the arrogance. It's kind of just, are you kidding me? But it worked out. They settled it. And they really did seem to be the end of it. Nobody cared after that.
So let's go ahead and run down a list of some of the major similarities between the two shows. After a certain point, this just becomes laughably ridiculous, as some of it is just downright disgraceful. Both shows were based aboard a space station that contained a single-digit number in its name. Babylon 5, obviously, Deep Space Nine. Both of these space stations were located near an intergalactic gateway of some kind. On Deep Space Nine, it was a wormhole. On Babylon 5, it was a jump gate. The shows both aired in 1993, and the space stations served as locations for intergalactic trade and diplomacy. The leading officers of both shows began with a backstory about having lost their wives. I'm referring, of course, to Sisko and Sheridan. On both shows, the main characters went on to have girlfriends who were both captains of freighter starships. On Deep Space Nine, that was Cassidy Yates for Sisko, and on Babylon 5, it was Caroline Sykes for Sinclair. Both shows introduced a warship in the third season that would feature prominently throughout the rest of the series. On Deep Space Nine, that was the Defiant, and on Babylon 5, that was the White Star. As you can probably gather at this point, these similarities can't be a coincidence, but there's so many more examples. On both shows, the primary character was influenced by a mysterious incorporeal species and went on to become a messianic spiritual leader and religious figure for an alien race. By the end of the series, both Sisko and Sheridan would ascend to a higher plane of existence, having fulfilled a prophecy. On Deep Space Nine, the higher dimensional spiritual beings were referred to as wormhole aliens or the prophets. On Babylon 5, they were the Vorlons. both of these species had an arch enemy, the Power Wraiths on Deep Space Nine and the Shadows on Babylon 5. Both of the space stations were run by an Earth-based military organization, the Federation on Deep Space Nine and the Earth Alliance on Babylon 5. Both governments ran the station with the assistance of a very religious alien race, the Bajorans on Deep Space Nine and the Mimbari on Babylon 5. Both shows built towards a major intergalactic war featuring massive fleet battles. On DS9, the war was with the Dominion. On Babylon 5, the war was with the Shadows. In the second last season of both shows, there was a significant six-part story arc as part of each show's respective war story. On both shows, the second-in-command officer was female and had lost a member of her family in a past conflict. On DS9, this was Kira Nerys. On Babylon 5, that was Susan Ivanova. As Patricia Tallman mentioned, both shows featured a female character called Lita, though the name wasn't spelt the same. Similarly, they both featured a character called Dukat, again with a different spelling of that name. There's several more similarities, but I think I've covered the most notable ones here. Feel free to comment below if you can think of any more that I haven't included, and I'll also include a link to a website with many more examples. As you can probably deduce, Deep Space Nine was more than just inspired by Babylon 5. Now, I personally love both shows, and as a fan, it was win-win because as far as I'm concerned, we got two great sci-fi shows and not one. Both series may have featured many of the same themes and story elements, but they both developed their own unique identities, and Deep Space Nine was still able to stand on its own as a fantastic series. But there's no doubt in my mind that Deep Space Nine ripped off Babylon 5 on multiple counts, and I can obviously understand why many people viewed what happened as unethical, because it was. Straczynski's work was clearly copied. He did manage to work in a small tongue-in-cheek dig at Deep Space Nine now and again, with one such example here.
Dolls, jackets, toys.
Welcome to Babylon 5, the last best hope for a quick buck.
Commander.
Oh, this is demeaning. I mean, we're not some Deep Space franchise. This station is about something.
Obviously a cheeky dig at the heavily funded and commercial Star Trek franchise, and a swipe specifically at DS9. In the end, both shows will be remembered as two iconic space sci-fi TV series of the 90s, despite the controversy surrounding DS9's development. DS9 was already grounded in the Star Trek mythology, and so was able to draw on that mythos in addition to incorporating Straczynski's ideas. This further strengthened the series and made it more complex, deep, and thematically rich in the Trek universe, but it can't take credit for being completely original. It owes its success to Babylon 5. As for which show was better, well, that's entirely up to you guys to debate below in the comments. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.